Japanese agricultural and construction machinery manufacturer Kubota celebrated its 50th anniversary in Europe in 2024. In this article, which we created entirely using our footage, we will show you some interesting future technologies that are being researched and developed. These include the new M7004 standard tractors, an autonomous version of which is currently being worked on by the Japanese. In 2019, Kubota founded the Innovation Centre Europe, or ICE for short. The team's task involves identifying new technologies, analysing their market suitability and steering development processes. ICE works with development engineers within the group, as well as with startups and partner companies. In 2021, Kubota invested in the Israeli startup Tammo, which specialises in fruit-picking robots. We were able to have a look at the technology in Italy as part of a product film shoot. The modular unit is equipped with up to 8 wired drones, which use software to identify the ripeness levels of the apples and gently pick the fruit from the tree. While this is taking place, yields and individual weights are recorded and sorted according to specified sizes and qualities. Drones can also work at greater heights, which can normally only be harvested using safety baskets. The developers are currently working on further improving the productivity and flight characteristics of the drone swarm. It is also about reducing noise emissions. Kubota and Tammo are anticipating that the first autonomous fruit pickers will go into series production in 2 to 3 years, and will also be able to work on other crops. Drones will also provide valuable data for orchard management in the future. The Netherlands-based company Aurea Imaging has been working since 2016 on using image recognition to analyse tree health in order to use the data to prepare fertilisation and care measures. Each individual apple or pear orchard can then be optimally supplied, and fertilisers and pesticides can be used in the quantities required. We were recently able to watch a demonstration of the K-Fast at a press event. A self-propelled sprayer for the precise and autonomous application of crop protection products. Two cameras in the front analyze the crop and open the nozzles individually only where there is vegetation. According to Kubota, the safety mechanism should be tested and approved to such an extent that the prototype can be tested extensively in practice as soon as this year. The K-Fast is steered manually with the aid of a remote control when changing fields. Last year, we had the opportunity to film UV boosting technology at two wineries in France. The vines are treated with UV light flashes to make them more resistant to frost, drought, and fungal infestations such as mildew. The technology has already been in use for several years by both conventional and organic customers. In addition to reducing the use of fungicides, the developers are also focusing on political efforts aimed at restricting the use of other crop protection products. The UV boosting modules are also being tested in an adapted format in other crops, such as strawberries and apples, and are also expected to deliver positive results in the treatment of green areas. Resource-conserving plant protection and care measures require close monitoring of the crops. Over recent years, Chouet has excelled in monitoring grape vines. Kubota invested in the French technology company in 2023. Data and disease patterns are collected every time the vineyard is crossed using sensors or a special algorithm, providing the farmer with a decision-making aid for the type and cost of plant protection measures. The sensors can be mounted on tractors, working machines, and also RTVs. Kubota is aiming to use the Innovation Centre Europe to identify future technologies, and in doing so, equip its own hardware with intelligence in a targeted manner. Even for one of the largest agricultural and construction machinery manufacturers globally, which employs more than 50,000 people and generates annual sales of over $20 billion, cooperation with highly specialized partner companies is the right way to achieve these goals. Another major challenge for the agricultural machinery industry is autonomous tractors. At Agritechnica 2023, all established agricultural machinery manufacturers presented corresponding solutions, some of which are not yet ready for the market for various reasons. Kubota has stated that it will be able to supply an autonomous version of the M7 for the European market in the near future. This is made possible by the technology partnership with Agreen Culture, whose products are approved for use with tractors in Europe, according to the company. We have already been able to film the autonomously operating M7 during soil cultivation. Only the physical definition of exact field boundaries is required to create an order. In manual mode, the tractor can also be used as a standard tractor to carry out transport tasks, for example. Kubota has been active in Europe since 1976 and also operates a number of factories and assembly plants here. The M7 series tractors are rolling off the production line in France. With a maximum of 175 horsepower, they will remain the manufacturer's most powerful tractors for the time being. With the three new tractors in the M7004 series, Kubota is now providing a number of updates, such as a modified access to the cab, a more accessible radiator, and the option of tractor implement management control. With TIM, attachments such as a round baler or a fertilizer spreader control various tractor functions, such as the PTO shaft, hydraulics, and speed. TIM also has access to the swiveling drawbar of the round baler, which ensures that the bale chamber is filled evenly and fully automatically. Kubota also announced its sales partnership with AgroIntelli from Denmark at the press event in Spain. Essentially, the aim is to make the Roboti implement carrier available to Kubota dealers. The 72-horsepower machine can carry out sowing and maintenance work autonomously, primarily in vegetable cultivation. According to AgroIntelli, 60 units of the implement carrier have already been sold in Europe over the last 3 years. The shortage of labour is also a major problem for vegetable farms. The machine can theoretically work autonomously day and night for up to 60 hours without refueling. For us, creating this video and researching the topics presented was an interesting insight into the research and development efforts for the land management of tomorrow. From our travels to North America, for example, we know that many technologies are already in widespread use there in a similar format. For this reason, it is still exciting to see how this topic will continue to develop in Europe.